Hallelujah, praise the Lord. This is Prophetic Intercession with Amel. You're welcome. If this is your first time seeing me, thank you so much for clicking on this video. I know it's not by coincidence. God wants you to hear this word that I'm about to release because it's going to be of great importance to you for the next year. And if this is not your first time, thank you, family, for always coming back. I love you and I pray for you always. It's been a couple of days, close to a week or so, God has been laying this word in my spirit and it's been coming up so strong. But for some reason, I didn't feel led to share it as a prophetic word. I knew there was more to it and I had not fully downloaded what it was all about, so I couldn't share it. I was just pondering on the word. What was God trying to tell me? What was the message he was trying to pass across? And I went to church on Sunday and boom, my pastor started talking about it, my spiritual father, and he talked about it in relation to next year. And I knew that that was what God was trying to tell me. It was not just any kind of prophetic word. It was a word he was releasing for next year. That is how God started talking to me. When I went to church, it was a huge confirmation about what God wants to do in the year 2022. The year 2022 is going to be an amazing year. It's going to be a great year, especially for the believers. For not just any kind of believer, but for someone who has aligned themselves. For someone who has aligned themselves to the will and the purposes of God. The Bible says in the book of Revelation chapter 3 and verse 16. So then, because you are lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will vomit you out of my mouth. That is the word God had been laying in my spirit for over a week now. He had been dealing with me on this word, and I couldn't say it. I couldn't speak it out, either as a prophetic word or anything, because I felt like there was more to it. And so I went to church, and my pastor started talking about the same thing, and that was a huge confirmation. God is saying for the year 2022, you've got to pick a camp. It's not a time when you play church and you are just in between. It's not a time when you come to God because of what you want. So many of us love God. We love the things that are around God, but we don't love God himself. We love the blessings he gives. We love the health he gives. We love the long life and prosperity he gives, but we don't love him as a being. We don't love him as someone we can surrender our lives to. We love everything that is around him except for him. But unfortunately for those category of people, the year 2022 is not going to be a good year for you, because it is a year that if you do not align yourself to the will and the purposes of God, you are going to be exempted on the plan of God. God has a great plan for Christians next year. It's going to be an amazing plan because God has a lot to do. There is no time. In less than no time, we are going to be checking out of this place. In less than no time, the rapture is going to come. And God is trying to do a lot on the earth right now with the remnants, with those that are still for him, with those that are still serving his agenda. So if you align yourself, it's going to be awesome. It's going to be a great year. But if you are in between, you're just going to get lost there because nothing will be happening to you and God will spit you out of his mouth. When God spits you out of his mouth, it is not a good day. It is a sad day because he delivers you to the devil. He says, I would prefer that you're even cold, so I know you are not for me. Because if you're lukewarm, you'll just be here. People will be thinking you're serving God, but your life is just going to remain the same because nothing good is going to be happening to you. But if you are hot, if you are hot in the things of God, God is going to use you amazingly next year to impact the world. God is going to use you as a witness of his love, as a witness of his greatness, as a witness that he can do great things in people's life. It's high time. Next year is the time when the scripture, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto you, is going to manifest like never before. In the year 2022, to as many as shall prioritize God, shall put him first in their list, he's going to add everything to you. He's going to add everything unto you, be it marriage, a godly marriage that is going to serve him, that's going to glorify his name. God is going to be blessing people abundantly with finances. People who are kingdom-minded, people who want to serve the agendas of God, people who want to propagate the gospel, God is going to be blessing you with finances amazingly more than ever before. The least thing you do is going to bring a lot of finances your way. The least move you take, what you used to do and make just a little, you are going to do maybe half of that, and God is going to reward it with so much financial blessing as long as you are serving his agenda. 2022 is the year of the Lord's agenda. It's the year of the Lord's agenda. As you align yourself to serve his purpose, as you put him first in your priority list, God is going to honor you. God is going to bless you like never before. God is in search of men. God is in need of men for what he has for next year. God cannot do anything on the earth except through the instrumentality of men. He is looking for people to serve his agenda next year. And if you align yourself according to that, God is going to bless you tremendously. You've got to rearrange your priorities. You've got to change your mindset. If you are coming to God because you've heard that God can bless you, God can change your life, that is awesome. It is true. But that should not be your main reason for coming to God. You should come to God because you've heard the message of the good news, you love him, and you want to serve his purpose. Next year is for people who want to serve the purposes of God. This message is coming to you right now so that you can go back on the drawing board and rearrange your priorities. Rearrange your priorities. Put God first in everything you do. If you're believing God for marriage, let it be that your marriage wants to serve a kingdom purpose. Your marriage wants to show the world that marriages still work. There are a lot of divorces out there and people just get married for the fun of it. People get married because they don't want to be tagged single. Maybe because they are lonely. Maybe because they have other agendas that have nothing to do with God. Change your priorities. Change your motive. If you want to get married, it should be because you want the kingdom of God to be glorified. You want your marriage to serve the kingdom of God. You want your marriage to be a godly union. It's going to show to the world that marriages still work. Not about all these divorces we see every day, but marriages still work. When that is your motive, when that is the reason why you want to get married, then God is going to bless you with a beautiful relationship. If the reason why you want to make money is because you just want to be comfortable, you just want to give your family a good life, that is a good reason, but it's not good enough to make God bless you. Change your motive. Use these remaining days of the year to change your motive. Link your finances to kingdom agendas. Link your finances to the work of God. If that becomes your focus, if that becomes why you want God to make you rich, why you want God to make you wealthy, because you want to sponsor kingdom agendas, that is a good reason, and God is going to bless you. Let every reason for your blessing be linked to kingdom agendas. The year 2022 is a year of God's agenda. It's a year of God's agenda. You cannot afford to be in between. You cannot afford to be lukewarm. You've got to choose a camp. If you are for the Lord, you've got to be hot. You've got to be on fire. You cannot just stay lukewarm and only shout amen to prophecies that are given to you. You've got to participate in serving God's agenda. You can't just sit back and you are shouting amen to everything, that to every word that is being released. You've got to be the reason why someone knows God. You've got to be the reason why someone is serving the Lord. In addition to what God is going to give you, in addition to the material blessings that God is going to give you by serving God's agenda next year, you are going to be preserved. You are going to be protected. It's going to be a catastrophic year for those who are lukewarm and those who are cold. Maybe those who are cold know where they stand. Maybe they have pledged their allegiance to the devil and they have some sort of coverage from him. But if you are just lukewarm and you are just in between, you don't have any coverage, anything can sweep you off. It's going to be a dangerous year for the lukewarm. Anything can sweep you off. You are going to be a casualty from the kingdom of darkness. You are going to be a casualty because God is not covering you. You do not have spiritual coverage because you are just coming to God for what he has. You are not serving his agenda. You are not serving his purposes. Therefore, he doesn't have any reason to keep you alive, to keep you healthy. But if you align yourself to serve God's agenda next year, you will be under divine protection. Nothing shall come against you, nor your household. Even you standing in front, you're going to serve as a coverage for your family. So aligning yourself to the purposes of God is not only for material blessings, it's also for spiritual coverage. It's also so that your family is exempted from the casualties that is going to be happening in the world next year. Things are not getting better, they are getting worse as the day goes by. We will hardly see a better tomorrow. We will hardly see a better tomorrow. Things are just getting worse. And our only hope and our only assurance is the fact that we love God, the fact that we are serving His purpose. That is the only way that we can stay protected. Times are becoming perilous as the days go by. It's becoming more difficult. It's becoming more difficult to stay alive. It's becoming more difficult to survive. Our only assurance is to be under the coverage of God. And when you are serving God's purpose, He cannot let you die untimely. He cannot let you be afflicted by the devil. He cannot let your finances be afflicted. He cannot let anything that concerns you be afflicted. One of the ways to stay protected next year is by serving God's agenda. Hallelujah. This message is coming your way right now so that you can go back and reflect. You can go back to your quiet time and realign your purposes and prioritize your purposes. Go back to your priority list and strike off some things and put God first. This coming year 2022, as you seek God, as you seek His kingdom and His righteousness, every other thing will be added unto you. You will lack nothing. You'll be under divine coverage. You and your family will be protected. You'll be exempted from casualties, and you are going to know peace and prosperity. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father Lord, we thank you for the privilege to show us the year before it happens. Thank you, Lord, for giving us this prophetic word that is going to serve as guidance for us, even as we enter into the year 2022. Lord, please help us to rearrange our priorities. Help us, oh God, to realign our mind according to your ways so that we may be able to serve your agenda for the year 2022. Lord, help us on our own. We cannot do this because we are mere mortals, we are flesh, but we know that with you we can do it. Help us to be able to rearrange ourselves, rearrange our priorities to fit into kingdom purposes. In the name of Jesus, amen. God bless you. Shalom.